In this calculus tutorial, I will show you guys how to use L'Hopital's rule to evaluate limits. So here's the first one. Notice when we're plugging 1 into all the x's, on the top this is 1 minus 2 plus 1, so we have 0. And then when we're plugging 1 here, 1 minus 1, so we also have 0 on the bottom. Remember, we must have either 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity in order for us to use L'Hopital's rule. So here, this satisfies the criteria, so we can use L'Hopital's rule, meaning that go ahead and differentiate the top and then differentiate the bottom. So here's the limit as x approaching 1. On the top, we get 3x squared for this derivative, and then this right here will give us negative 4x. And then differentiate x to the third power minus 1, we get 3x squared. Here, you can factor out the x and then simplify a little bit, but x is just approaching 1. We can plug in a number and then calculate this. So we will have 3 times 1 squared minus 4 times 1 over 3 times 1 squared. This is just 3 minus 1. Sorry, 3 minus 4 is negative 1 over 3 times 1, which is just 3. In another word, negative 1 third. Done. Here's another limit. Well, let's go ahead and plug in 0 into all the x's. Here, e to the 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, and then minus 0 on the top, we do get 0. On the bottom, we have 0 squared, is of course 0. So we can use L'Hopital's rule. Here we go. Let me just write that down right here for you guys. Go ahead, differentiate the top, and then differentiate the bottom. So this becomes the limit as x approaching 0. The derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. The derivative of minus 1 doesn't matter. The derivative of minus x is negative 1. And then the derivative of x squared is 2x. Now, can we calculate this? Well, if we put 0 into here, e to the 0 is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. If we put 0 here, 2 times 0, 0. So we have another 0 over 0. Therefore, go ahead and just use L'Hopital's rule again. So, let's do this again. Here, this becomes, let me write down the limit first. And then, of course, differentiate the top, and then differentiate the bottom. On the top, we get what? Just e to the x. On the bottom, the derivative of 2x is just 2. Yeah. And then finally, plugging 0 into here, we will just have e to the 0th power over 2, which is just 1 over 2, and then we're done. All right, here's another example. We have the limit as x approaching pi over 2 plus, and then we have cosine x over 1 minus sine x. As always, plugging this into all the x's, cosine of pi over 2 is 0, and then sine of pi over 2 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So we get to use L'Hopital's rule. And here we go. Let me just write this down right here for you guys. And let's go ahead and differentiate the top and also differentiate the bottom. This becomes the limit as x approaching pi over 2 plus. And even though this is a one-side limit, but don't worry, all right? This right here still works. On the top, what do we have? The derivative of cosine x is negative sine x. And then for the bottom, the derivative of 1 is 0. The derivative of negative is still negative. The derivative of sine x is cosine x. So we have cosine x like this. And now check this out. This and that becomes positive, of course. Sine x over cosine x is just tangent x. So this question becomes, what's the limit as x approaching pi over 2 from the right-hand side, and then we're just looking for the tangent x function. So how do we do this? Well, in fact, if you plug in pi over 2 into here and here, you will end up with 1 over 0. And remember, for this limit form, either we get past infinity or negative infinity. We have to just observe the sign, right? Either positive or negative sign. But once you have tangent, you can also just think about the graph of tangent x, and I'll just write that down for you guys right here. So here is the graph for tangent x. We have 30 isotopes for tangent, And the first one is at pi over 2, right here. So this is pi over 2. And then the other one right here is negative pi over 2. And the graph looks like this. So just go up like this, and then like that. And then, of course, we have many, many copies of that, infinitely many copies of that. So this right here is y equals tangent x. Now, we have this graph in mind, right here. Not in mind, just right in front of us. What's the limit as x approaching pi over 2 from the right-hand side? Have a look. Pi over 2 is here. Use your right hand or right finger. You see, the curve goes straight down, right? The curve goes straight down. Therefore, the answer to that is negative infinity. Yeah, just like that. Now let's take a look at this limit. We have the limit as x approaching 0, cosine of some number m times x, minus cosine of some number n times x over x squared. So right here, m and n, they are just some constants. So our answer most likely will end up with in terms of m or n, right? So keep that in mind. Well, let's see. Plugging 0 into all the x's, this will become cosine 0, which is 1, minus another cosine 0, which is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. And then on the bottom, you can guess it. You guess 0, so L'Hopital's rule. Okay, here we go. Use L'Hopital's rule, and then let's go ahead and differentiate the top, and then differentiate the bottom. So here we get the limit as x approaching 0. Okay, here you have to be careful with the chain rule, because if you don't use the chain rule, of course, that's the common mistake, right? The derivative of cosine is negative sine, and then we have the mx. Then we multiply by the derivative of mx, which is m. So let me just multiply by that right here. Then we bring down the minus, but the derivative of cosine is negative sine. So this becomes plus, and then we have sine of nx. And then just like that, we multiply by the derivative of nx, which is n. And then over the derivative of that, which is 2x. Okay. Now, check this out. If we put 0 into here and here, on the top will be 0 again, and on the bottom, we get 0 again. Therefore, we have to use L'Hopital's rule one more time. So let's just go ahead and do it. Here we go. Let me just write down d dx, and then d dx. All right, so this is L'Hopital's rule. Here we get the limit as x approaching 0. All right, the derivative of sine is cosine, and then we have mx, yeah? But here we have a negative, and then here we have the m from earlier, okay? So let me just bring the m here, and the derivative of sine is cosine, write that already. Then we have to use the chain rule one more time, right? We have to use the chain rule right here. The derivative of mx is m, so we multiply this by m, which in fact we get m squared. And then right here, same thing. So let me just put down plus, and then let me put down the n, and then the derivative of sine is cosine, and then the nx stays, and then multiply by the derivative of nx, which is n. So that's what we have. Okay, and then on the bottom, we have 2. And now you see there's no more x on the bottom. You know we're on the right track. So now we just have to kind of write this down. When x is 0, this is 1, that's 1, so that's very nice. So in fact, let me just... Okay, I'll write this down. So this becomes negative m times n, which is m squared times cosine of m times 0, right? And then plus n times n, which is n squared, and then times cosine of n times 0. And then all over 2. But as I said, this right here is just 0, and this right here is just 0. So cosine 0 is 1. Cosine 0 is 1. So this right here altogether is just negative m squared plus n squared over 2. Or usually you like to write down the positive term first. So maybe let's write this as n squared minus m squared over 2. And that's the final answer. I think the result is pretty nice. All right, here we have the limit as x approaching infinity of ln x to the second power over x. First off, These two cannot be brought to the front because this means we have ln x times ln x, right? When we have the square like this. When we have ln parentheses x squared like this, this means x times x inside of the ln, and then you can bring the 2 to the front, right? So this is okay, but not that. So just deal with it like that. Okay, as always, let's go ahead and plug in infinity into all the excess and see what happens. When we put infinity to ln, ln infinity is infinity. Square that, we still get infinity. So this time we have infinity on the top over, of course, infinity on the bottom. L'Hopital's rule. Yes. So here we go. L'Hopital's rule. Let's go ahead and differentiate the top and then also differentiate the bottom. So here we will have the limit as x approaching infinity. So right here, remember, we will have to look at this like a box to the second power, differentiating that, put a 2 to the front, and a minus 1, so we have 2 ln x, and then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of ln x, and that's 1 over x. And we are done for that. Then for the bottom, the derivative of x is just 1. And I can rewrite this a little bit. This is just the limit as x approaching infinity. In fact, we can just put the x down here. So this is just 2 ln x over x. But if you put infinity to here and here, once again, we will end up with infinity over infinity. So it's okay. Let's just use L'Hopital's rule. D dx here, likewise d dx here. So we will have the limit as x approaching infinity. Now the derivative of 2 times ln x is just 2. You just keep that, and the derivative of ln x, and the derivative of ln x is just 1 over x, just that. And you don't have to use the product rule. Constant multiple, you just maintain that, and you multiply by the derivative of that. If you use the product rule, then you keep the second function, ln x, times the derivative of the first. Derivative 2 is just 0, so you really don't need to use that. Just put it down like this. Then the derivative of x is just 1. So in fact, this is just asking us what the limit is when x is approaching infinity of 2 over x. And you can put infinity here, you will just get 0, because maybe perhaps already done right here for you guys. It's like this, 2 over infinity, and you get 0. Okay. Remember, a finite number over infinite, we get 0. Yeah, so that's it.